All right, hi everyone. So, Gabe here again, back for part three of the FF8 walkthrough. So, like I had said in my previous video, just be absolutely 100% certain to have draw equipped on at least one of your characters for this here upcoming fight. Sorry about that, guys. So for this fight here, the first part is basically just facing off against weaklings, so don't really worry about anything, you know, when it comes to using GFs or anything like that. You can basically just draw and cast their magic on themselves. Well, yeah, that works well. Other than that, you know, simple attacks, whatever. For this first part, quite simple. some reason the Elvret's not spawning in, so I'm just gonna cast a GF here. There you go. So upon this enemy spawning in, you really, really want to draw Siren from him right off the bat. Then you can kind of just let it loose with GFs. I suggest not spamming Quetzalcoatl too much though, because you're really going to need him in the next fight. And if he takes too much damage here and dies in the next fight, that might prove to be a problem. So, since the Elvret attacked the Quetzalcoatl, I'm going to go ahead here and use Zell to cure some characters, keep their HP on the higher end. Since that cure was about as useful as a swift kick in the butt, I'm just going to go ahead and use potions. Actually, come to think of it there, I should have stalked some Thunders instead with Zell. They're going to be useful in the next battle. So now that Zell is in yellow colored HP, I'm gonna try and spam so I could get his dual limit break. Now, since it's gonna be the first time doing this in this here current walkthrough, I'm gonna show you a little cheese, you could say, with the dual limit break for Zell. Quite basically, you want to pause the game as the combo appears on screen, and I'll give you some time to see what the combo is and which one you want to input at which point. The Mac kick in this instance being the one that you want to go with, it's kind of, what's the term I'm looking for here? Basically pre-recorded, if you will, in the game, or pre-programmed. There you go. That's the term I was looking for, pre-programmed. If you go with the Mac kick, it'll unlock a path that will allow Zell to do his limit break burning rush early in the game. So then you want to go with the punch rush, which was the OX. Then it'll do the heal drop. And here you should have access to Burning Rave. You don't necessarily need to do it right now. If you go back with a Mach kick, you basically start a loop, an infinite loop, where you could go Mach kick, Burning Rush into Heal Drop into Burning Rave. So, yeah, basically that's what you want to do. Pushing my luck a little bit here on time to input the final one. I don't think I will have time. Nah, I just missed it by about half a second there. So I'm gonna go ahead and heal Zell here, but with Selfie so that I can get one more limit break with Zell. One more hit. Or maybe not. So you get Siren from draw. You will have here a 30-minute timer, but you're still gonna have time enough to at least just equip the GF and choose the basic ability that you wanted to learn for starters. With Siren, I suggest life magic refining as early as possible, as it will unlock the potential of creating death magic for your status junction, which Siren has, and also Kuraga, which early game putting your HP really gives you massive amounts of early HP. Just gonna go ahead and heal Zell here, and doesn't really matter on whom we put Siren for now. We're also just gonna be sure that she's learning the right ability. Yeah, indeed. boost for Sarin isn't all that great, even in the original version of the game, simply because Sarin is not a GF that does a lot of damage. It's more of a negative status effect GF, which can silence the enemies. So since she doesn't do much damage, I don't suggest prioritizing boost for her. We're just going to go ahead and save real quick here, just in case something goes horribly wrong in the next part. So, for this boss here, it's basically not beatable. You can, it'll give you a little bit of extra points. Some people, you know, have done it online. Since I haven't done any form of, you know, farming or boosting for my strength, I would not be strong enough at this point in the game to defeat it. So, since it's a machine and it's weak to lightning, just go ahead and Quetzalcoatl it. Basically, it should, quote unquote, get stunned, I guess you can say. You're going to see damage. It's going to kind of fall down and allow you to run away. Usually after one summoning of Quetzalcoatl, it should fall down. If not, do a normal attack or two. Another Quetza, just in case, while still doing some normal attacks, in case it falls. So once it falls like this, then you can escape. So of course, do so. Now, if for the next part here, just hold left as much as you can. Not this one, the next one. For the next screen right after this one, if you hold left as fast as you can, right off the bat, if you just hold it, you should be able to skip a fight with him. As so. But if you did not do that, upon him jumping there, you will get a fight. Now here, the fight is unavoidable. As for your HP, as long as you've got Selphie, don't really worry about that. Selphie's got a limit break called Full Cure that really does exactly as the name implies. It just fully heals everyone. Unfortunately, I skipped the full cure. Just do over, and eventually you'll have it cast. It'll fully heal everyone. So here you're gonna have to be quick. Just hold the down button, but if you're not quick enough, it may catch up to you. If you do it this way, you avoid a fight. This way, this fight here is unavoidable. It will simply jump across and come face to face with you. Same principle. Spam Guiza. You could do some other GFs, but considering that your seed level is nonetheless based on the amount of time that there is remaining, it is not something I suggest you do simply because the animations are long. But at the same time, whether you're like, I don't know, 17 minutes remaining, suppose, versus 15, it's not as if it's going to have that much of an impact either. So it's up to you. Surprising, didn't fall after two summons of Quetzalcoatl. Might have been put at the limits there too quickly. Might be a waste of time if they proc them. No? Great. Fantastic. So don't worry about your HP. That was basically the final fight with it. Just run across. Here, just hold down. Thank you. So if you want, you can go ahead and rest at the hotel that's right here in the room. You'll also have access to, what's it called again? One of those timber maniacs, there you go, which you do need to acquire for the platinum trophy. It's right here on the table. I'm just going to go ahead and save. I won't rest here simply because if we do get into a battle, I can just use Selfie's full cure instead, since she's in the limit break HP range. This is Zell's house. Okay, so at this point you can't play against Ma Ditched yet. Alright. Eventually you'll be able to play cards against her. I thought you could at this point, but obviously I was mistaken. There was a weapon shop there for a moment. I thought about going, but then I realized don't have card mod yet, so don't have any items required to boost any items, weapons rather.
Thank you.
So here, just be patient, talk to people. Eventually, they'll arrive to announce that you've made it to be a seed. To being a seed, rather. Sorry. So here, be sure to talk with the Headmaster. He's gonna give you a battle meter. Now they're gonna let you know what your seed level is. And the first thing that you're gonna wanna do is complete as many seed tests to increase your seed level as much as you can. Basically, you can't complete a higher seed test in your current actual level. Getting it as high as soon as possible will get you as much money as possible. It's actually really important early game to be able to purchase tents, which, like I mentioned a little bit earlier, or was in a previous video, not sure, but regardless, will allow you to get some early Karakas into your HP junction mainly, which will give you some really high levels of HP. So for the seed test, it's quite simple. You go here in tutorial, you do tests. You can find a list of these very easily online, pretty much anywhere. So I'm just going to go ahead and input them as fast as I can here. I myself do not remember the answers by heart. I too simply look online for a list of answers. So just going to go ahead and input those as quick as I can here. Alright, so since I'm level 9, I can't get any higher than this level for now. Of course, don't forget, you don't necessarily need to do it each and every level you gain, but, you know, here and there, don't forget to go back and increase your seed levels. And if you want to be diligent, and do it on each and every level that you gain, hey, what might have stopped you? So here, if you're interested in being part of the Garden Festival Committee, by all means, answer yes, I guess so. I, however, have no interest in such things, so we'll simply do this. It doesn't really add anything to the story. You don't really have any extra quests or any XP or any reward for doing it. So, since there's no incentive, I don't see the point. So I usually don't, you know, so far in these videos, haven't spoken that much of the story or anything like that. But in this video, I really can't help myself because basically I find it about as, you know, believable as rainbows and unicorns and leprechauns that someone who can't dance in a matter of whatever, a couple of minutes, hours maybe, gets as good as what this guy is going to be at a certain point in this video. Speaking of someone who cannot dance, that's probably why I have such a hard time leaving. goes from a clumsy fool to this in a matter of moments. Sure. Basically, here are going to be going into the training center area. There's two types of enemies, a Gratz and a T-Rexor. While T-Rexor will end up being very easy to beat quite shortly, at this point, though, since we do not have the death spell quite yet, we're waiting on that Life Junction ability to be learned, but since we don't have them quite yet, well, they're going to be quite impossible. Well, I mean, it could be possible to beat, but not quite worth the time. Basically, at this stage would be with sleep, which you can draw from the Gratz, and you just keep them asleep while you do damage on them. But considering their levels of HP, the fight's actually going to be quite long, and again, when it comes to efficiency, just not efficient at all. So I suggest just running away from those battles for now until you do have the death spell equipped in your status attack. If, unlike me, you've grinded a little bit of AP here, and you do have the life magic refining ability, by all means, go ahead and craft some deaths and equip them to your status junction. So I'm going to just show you real quickly where that would go. Okay, I'm going to have to remove the GFs from the other people. The reason why I'm equipping two on each is simply because the XP is actually split between the amount of characters, well, or GFs that you have. So if you have got three on one person, on one character, and simply one GF on another one, well, the character that has three GFs will those specific GFs will have less XP learned. Now, as for the status attack, well, whomever you put Siren on, basically, this is where you'd go. You'd click here, and your death spells that you would have crafted would be there. To craft your death spells, not switch one, my apologies, would be through ability. But since we don't have one yet, well, I can't quite show you. But basically, you'd click on this. You'd have the life magic ability in this here list. Click on it, convert your chief's knives into deaths. Now, again, come to think of it, to be able to do that, that also mean that you'd learn enough AP to learn your card mod ability. If you haven't done that yet, well, again, you won't be able to equip your deaths in your status attack junction. So again, since we don't have those for the T-Rex, we're just going to flee. The other enemies are Grats. Quite simple. You can draw from them or just attack them. They're quite weak. So no need to worry about that. So these are the Grat enemies. So when it comes to drawing, basically they have sleep. And I don't quite remember for the other magic. Let's find out. But sleeps is basically the better spell that they have. Right, silence. So if you want, go ahead and draw until you've got 100 of each. I won't be doing that because, again, through card mod, you can get a bunch of items, and you're just going to be refining those into magics. So you don't really need to waste your time just drawing spells. Antidotes to remove Quistus's poison. So I'm just going to go ahead and use a tent here. We'll heal everyone and remove the poison. Save. And go where we need to go. Thank you. right, so I'm going to go ahead and save once more and leave this video here for now. And I thanks for you guys for being there, and see you in the next one. All right, see you soon.